So here I am making another RPG video. A couple months ago, I released a video discussing my opinion on the turn-based RPG genre, and let's just say that video got some mixed reviews. It's funny because it's actually one of my most popular videos, and because of that, I got a ton of comments. But one comment caught my attention. If I could find it, I'd probably put it on screen, but I probably most likely won't. But somebody mentioned that I was talking about RPGs, but used Sekiro gameplay. Now, initially, I just assumed that Sekiro was an action RPG, but after talking with the user, I realized that Sekiro isn't an RPG at all. So this is what kind of sparked this video. There's actually a difference between an RPG and an action game, and sometimes I kind of get the two confused. So today we're going to discuss the distinction between the two and hopefully find like a better understanding. Of course, by now you guys already know the drill. If you're new here, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We're so close to 200 subs and I know we can hit it pretty soon. Anyways, my name is Kwesi and this is Just a Game. Now, what is an RPG? Well, this is a really complex question, and actually completely answering it might make this video a whole lot longer, so I'm gonna try to answer it to the best of my ability. So, RPG stands for role-playing game. Now, many of you might know there are different types of RPGs, with the original being a tabletop RPG. Games like Dungeons & Dragons should come to mind. But the most popular types are action, turn-based, and MMORPG. Think of games like Dark Souls, Final Fantasy 13, and Persona 5. Although these games vastly differ in gameplay, they are all still RPGs. But let's dig a little bit further. What are elements that make a game an RPG? The first criteria is some sort of character customization. This can be from simply changing the clothes, to customizing your character's equipment, skill sets, and most importantly, their decisions. I think the biggest factor that makes an RPG is decision making. Every decision you make should in some way impact the story and the world around you. I think this is why the genre is so popular, because being able to control the way the game functions and plays really makes a player feel like they are the character they're playing as. And because of all the choices and the directions that RPGs provide, it's hard to see everything the game has to offer. And this leads me to my next criteria, replayability. Like I said, RPGs typically have you making tough decisions that might have you miss out on other things. This is the biggest difference from RPGs and regular games. Most games, if you play enough, you could potentially see everything the game has to offer. So unlike RPGs, you don't have an incentive to replay the game. Let's take a game I recently platinumed, Spider-Man Miles Morales. Now, I got the platinum on my first playthrough. Yes, it took me forever, but after doing it, I never really had a desire to play the game again because I've seen everything. Now let's take a game like Pokemon. Even though these games are relatively short, there's still a lot of things you can do within these games to change up every playthrough. For example, you can go through the game with a different starter Pokemon, or you could do what I used to do as a kid, which is you put your starter Pokemon in the PC and catch other Pokemon and use that as a starter. Yeah, I was a really creative kid. There's also challenges like the Nuzlocke, where if a Pokemon on your team faints, you can no longer use them for the rest of the game. All these things give the game so much replayability on top of the content the game already has to offer. Now let's quickly change topics and talk about action games. The word action is pretty broad because technically any game can be considered an action game. However, for the sake of this video, I'll be talking about action games that share RPG elements. So a lot of these games have similarities to RPGs, but there's a slight difference. I want to introduce you guys to a term called linear progression. Now the best way I can describe this is a scripted progression system, where the game dictates how strong your character will be and what moves they will learn. Let's take a game I mentioned earlier, Spider-Man Miles Morales. As you increase in level, Miles learns new skills and techniques. However, you don't choose where these skill points go to. As you can see, every time you level up, you get a +1 in attack and a +1 in defense. You can't control where you want to put these attributes. Another game that does more of an extreme version of this is Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. There are certain sections where you come into the game at a certain level, and the game instantly boosts your level by like 20 just to advance the plot. Now, I'm not trying to say this is a bad tactic, I'm just pointing out the difference. Heck, some RPGs also share a linear progression. Let's take a look at Pokemon. As you level up your Pokemon, they will also learn certain moves at certain levels. Also, each Pokemon has a scripted level where they will evolve. The difference is the choices. You see, each Pokemon has different natures and abilities. These factors can dictate how the Pokemon levels up and which stats will be prioritized. Remember how I said each Pokemon learns certain moves at certain levels? Well, if you breed Pokemon, the offspring will learn different moves as well. So you see, with RPGs, there is more of a control, whereas with action games, the progression is kind of scripted. Now here comes the interesting part. Throughout my life, whenever I see a game with RPG elements, I instantly classify them as an RPG. When in reality, these games are just action games. Sekiro: Shadows Die Twice is a game I mentioned earlier, so I generally thought it was an RPG when I put in my video. However, if you dissect the game, you can clearly see that it's not. For starters, there isn't a sense of customization. You are given a character to play as, and you cannot customize his weapon, armor, or appearance. There also isn't a real leveling system, so the progression is linear. Whenever you defeat a boss, you gain a new skill. I think because it was made by From Software, me and many other people assumed that it was an RPG, but as we go down the checklist, it falls further away from that. Another game I want to bring up is Kingdom Hearts, specifically Kingdom Hearts 3. Now, I want to mention there's a difference between an RPG and a JRPG. JRPG, of course, stands for Japanese role-playing game. The difference is what they have to offer, but I'm not going to go into detail in this video. I'll leave that for another one. Now, let's go back to Kingdom Hearts. So, Kingdom Hearts, at first glance, seems like an RPG. It has a leveling system, weapon customization, a magical system, and heck, even party members. So if the game hits all the marks, well then, what's the problem? So, let's go back to what I said earlier about RPGs. Typically, they let you control the game. Your decision and actions dictate how the game will play. In Kingdom Hearts, you play as Sora. Although you do control Sora's actions, this only applies to combat. No matter what you do with Sora in the world, the story doesn't change. The leveling in the game is also really linear. You can't control Sora's stats. The game kind of picks and chooses. However, in the start of the game, it does ask you how you want Sora to develop. You can choose between magic, defense, or attack. But after you make your choice, the game literally curates the build for you. You can't create how you want Sora to perform. And lastly, the weapons are given to you for simply completing the respective world. So in essence, the only thing you have to worry about is battling. This is why I can't really say Kingdom Hearts is a full-fledged RPG, because in reality, it's more of an action hack and slash with RPG elements. So now let's look at some action RPGs that actually fit the RPG criteria. Nier Automata is a game that I talk about a lot on the channel. I feel like it's the blueprint of what an action RPG should be like. For starters, you do play as different characters throughout the game, so the game doesn't revolve around one character. However, the level and progression is shared by all the characters. This game does have a level of customization and player choice. Even though it's not that strong here, you do have a control of how the game will play out. The way the leveling works is also interesting here. As you level up, the only thing you gain is more health. If you want to increase your attack or your abilities, you have to use a chip system. This is like any regular skill tree, but you get to pick and choose what abilities and stats you want on your character. So as you can tell, the customization and options in Nier Automata is way much more flexible than the one in Kingdom Hearts. I think this is what it really comes down to, flexibility. Flexibility is what defines RPGs. The ability to dictate how your character develops, how the story progresses, down to which stats you want, is what RPGs are all about. Action games, and even those with RPG elements, just don't have this flexibility. But that isn't a bad thing. I believe that action games want you to focus solely on the combat. They don't want you to worry about stats and armor. When I reflect back on Kingdom Hearts, even when I played it on critical mode, the stats were never the reason why I lost majority of my battles. It was due to my reaction times and knowledge of the boss. But when I go back to play games like Final Fantasy X, most of the times when I lose to a boss, it's because I don't have the right equipment or I'm extremely underleveled. Action RPGs are a really good blend between the two genres. Games like Nier Automata perfectly blend the RPG formula with weapon hunting, customization, and exploration, all with high intense action combat that might put your reaction time to the test. And I can honestly understand why so much people prefer this subgenre of RPG over anything else. The goal of this video isn't to sit there and tell you that one genre is better than the other, but instead, kind of give you an understanding of each genre, and hopefully you have a better insight when jumping into your next game. Anyways, this is the end of the video, and like always, if you enjoyed, make sure you hit that like button. It really does help out the channel. And also, like I said earlier, if you're new here, make sure you hit the subscribe button. We're almost at 200 subscribers, and I think we can hit it pretty soon. Anyways, my name is Clacy, and this was Just a Game.